You know what I'm saying? Alright, let's see. Who should we start with? Alright, let's go. Let's see see how Krim, the IGL for Awakening, is doing over here on this side. Alright. So it looks like smoke's on Krim's. Jason Man buys a Kevlar. Drop P250, alright? Let's see. Interesting. They stack up ramp. Venus is playing 3A2B at the moment. As Awakening pushes up mid. Jason Man 3. Fucking frozen. Smoke going towards boiler. Let's see if they push archway. Oh, they smoke both sides. What are they doing?
Man, what are they
doing? Destroyed by Epicenter with high explosive. That's a double kill. It's a 3-5 situation for Awakening as they push through the smoke to 2 boilers. Aristotle gets a Glock 18 kill and Florin gets the pick on Aristotle. What a good trade. But it is not enough for a 2v4. Jason Man still stuck at ramp. He was frozen at ramp. And Heartless just walked right by him. I guess if he's a 50 kill. Jason baiting his team. Misses all of his shots. Heartless. And in change of shots, Epically gets the pick on Jason Man 3. And if you look at Epically, it looks like he's like shift glitched or some shit. I don't fucking
know. He's for me too.
Yeah. What a ninja.
Yeah.
1-0 for Cadence at the moment.
I'm calling it 8-4 half.
Looks like Awakening equals into this round. Looks like they're not going to challenge the economy. Cadence. As we have Bionify scouting. What a... Wow. Agents by ninjas, what can I say about that? I could say that Jason Man 3 just got destroyed by Sir Yellow Snow. Jesus Christ. But we also have Florin getting a pick on Krim Z. Awakening works their way into as the Scenix gets destroyed by P50 by Florin and Heartless get the SSG pick kill on Aristotle. Last Awakening player. All up to Doja Dog with skill. In the window room. Soundhorn. Waiting. Patiently. Eden's just, you know, just running around. They're like, yo, we got this. Oh, Doja Dog skill. Thinking about running out. He jumps out. He's crawling. Sneaking.
What's this thing?
Phoenix could have heard this. Would they? No, they did not. But they see him. Thorn gets to pick up the P50. It's a 2-0 for Phoenix right now. It's a big struggle for Awakening. If they can't get this, if they can't get at least one round by next round, then, you know, it's over for them. In my opinion, because if you lose 3 rounds, their economy is gonna be insane. And especially since they just like flawless them, only losing 1 casualty in the beginning round, that's like it's a lot for the eco. But I don't know if I see 3 of them pushing up banana, oh 4 as a matter of fact. And they get destroyed like by that one nade.
Hello.
I'm just holding mid. As we have a lurker for Awakening Album in TF. Awakening starts to push into B. Let's see how Heartless and Bot Spam control this. Oh, it looks like Heartless gets a pick with the P50 and Bot Spam gets a PP Bison kill, and Heartless gets another SSG tag. It is 5v2 situation. Oh, 1v5 all for Aristotle, who has 150 ping.
Yeah.
Bro, shut up. Anyways, we have Aristotle over here in CT lurking. 1 heart left. Let's see if he could get put any damage into the Cadence economy, which is right now insanely strong. And he gets destroyed by Sir Yellow Snow.
Casualty, bro. Another clean.
There has not been a casualty for 2 straight rounds.
3-0 Cadence.
Okay, if Awakening loses this full buy round, then it's over for them. Inferno. Okay, so it looks like Cadence is doing their original strat, putting 3A2B. As Awakening sends up 4 people rushing up alt mid. Lauren seizes. Epically gets the pick with the op. What a pick. He gets their lurker at TM. As Awakening makes her way into apps, Cadence are aware of this. So Yellowstone falls back into bottom. Falls back to pit. His main just ricochets off everything, you know? What the fuck? 2 balcony for Awakening right now. As one of them make their way into archway, Heartless gets the pick with the M4A4. And they throw a nade. See what this does to Krim Z. There's 2 on 3 on A site. Oh, Jason Man gets a this shot on Heartless. Improving your situation. A retake for Cadence. Bot spam and FFP versus Jason Man. Crims and Doge and Dog of Skill. Alright. We have Epically scoping in from library side. As the other Cadence member works his way into apps. Awakening just waiting patiently. Sanhorn their guts out. Those are all the skill pieces. We can get the pick, but trade it out. All of the bottom is destroyed by Jason. But a fucking Wandy, go what the fuck? God damn, that deke spam coming in clutch.
Bot spam, deke spam.
Well, even though Awakening won that round, they took more of an economic, like, you know, a dent in the economy more than Cadence. Oh my god, really quality buy. One of them has pistol armor. As Awakening does the same strat as last round. With a lurker. T ramp, which is Jason this time. Awakening makes their way into apps. Cadence playing this super passively. Nobody pushed up apps. So Yellowstone falls back off balcony quickly. Goes to graveyard, which as of now has been nerfed. Can't really use graveyard that much. Awakening makes their way into boiler. Three of them in ops. One pushing a balcony. See what happens. So you let's know pre-firing. Floor and pre-firing. We have two Awakening members top mid pushing in. Phoenix gets picked off by Heartless and Aristotle with the 847 off Sir Yellow Snow. Epically gets a pick on Doge of Dog of Skill. And Florian gets another pick. It's a 4v2 situation for Jason and Crims. Crims gets an AK kill on Heartless at Archway. He makes his way over to B. Jason makes his way into Archway as well. But looks like Crims is going through library. Phoenix is well aware of this as they start pre-firing. It looks like Jason gets the pick. 2v2 situation. Crims at one heart. Jason gets another pick. All up to Jason with two hearts and Epically gets a pick on the double kill. Oh my god. Woo! He gets a double kill to clutch the round. Cadence is now winning 4-1 and Awakening's economy is literal shit.
They have two people on 0-5, bro.
With an AK. Typically with an AK. Sir Yellow Snow gets a pick on Aristotle with a Deagle. What a good pick. I like how Cadence switches it up out of nowhere. They go from a nice passive hold to like an aggressive play on their eco round. So Yellow Snow gets two picks this round. Heartless gets one with a Stair Aug. What a douchebag, man. See the guy tree
yo,
and
AK-47.
All up to Doge of Dog of Skill, who is now going 0-4. Back from 1-4. He's finishing off Lauren, but Epically finishes him off. Epically gets screenshotted. Let's see. He is raying, guys! No, I'm joking.
It didn't send a link. Did it send a link?
No. Nice mod, Furlough. Fuck you. Alright, so it looks like Cadence puts 3A again. As Awakening make their way, and they're pushing on full eco. Cadence flash and nading. And Scenix gets the high explosive kill. Finally, first kill of the game on round 6. On round 7, as a matter of fact. Cadence a little weird here. Okay. Floor to Yellow Snow. Straight Yellow Snow Heartless. Oh my god, 4v1. They just got mowed down like some grass. God damn. Call them Grassening. Their name is Grassening right now, folks. Grassening.
Technically, it's 10 and 2.
6-1 for Cadence right now. Looks like Awakening is buying into it. As you could tell, the economy is so low, they can't even afford helmets at this point. As Epically gets to pick on Jason Man 3 with the off. Jason is now going 5-6.
7?
Oh, 5-6.
Oh, I think you're around.
Don't call me a kid because I know.
Man, go on. And a purple exchange. It's real from the pick off the frame with a defense. And epically gets a story by seeing it through 3 minutes. But Florin gets a trade off of him with an AKS shot. As Florin gets picked off by Dojo Dog's skills. 3v2 situation for Awakening on round 8. What a smart play by Bossman, this anchoring B-site, as he tries to rotate, and he gets picked off by Dojo Dog's skill. Dojo's Dog with only one heart left. Aggressive. Let's see if he gets the pick. Oh, that's Ayastaro, what the fuck type of enemies? Do they push up in CT? Why are they pushing up? Looks like they have the bomb down, but Sir Yellowstone gets destroyed by Ayastaro before he dies. Looks like it's 6-2 for Awakening. What are your thoughts on this game so far, Dude Z?
Oh, it's not as close as I was expecting it to be, you know?
Yeah. They're just getting fucked right now.
I think, like, Kane's, like, more, like, balanced as far as their members go. Like, more consistently like, playing together. But Awakening isn't.
It is I understand, like, though. The big roster, like... Yeah. Cadence forces them to play with each other, like Virtus Pro, for example. Playing with each other for so many years. They just have that constant chemistry. Fuck. And Bionify gets a pick on Dojo Dog's skill with the AWP. RJ, as a ex-Cadence member, what do you have to say for your ex-team?
I hate you.
Oh, as an ex-Awakening member, what do you have to say for your whole game?
I'm
ex-Belief, don't worry.
Bad plays.
Do you think they would win if you were still on the team?
Yes. Where you take out Phoenix coming in? Anyways, 45-3 for Awakening. Krims makes his way up into the banana, but he falls back. Epically gets a pick on Phoenix, and Aristotle gets a trade off on him. This 4v3 situation for Awakening as they push CP to B right now. Krims pushes his way back up to the bananas. 2v3 hold for Cadence right here. And the other two Cadence members all the ice with the ice. Ionify gets the pick up the hawk. Boss spam gets the M4A4 kill. Last guy, all the way in the graveyard. Pushing on fire. Had to get the pick. Beast Man gets the pick. 2v1 situation. He's stuck in the corner. Rifle sprays. Beast Man gets the other pick. 1v1 situation. All of four. Lauren, and he gets the pick if he's walking. Oh my god, 7-2 for Cadence. I don't know. I think their CT side is really good, but unfortunately, I'm not sure about their T side.
They have no IGL.
Yeah. Their IGL is like high, and he's not even playing. And considering how passively Sir Yellowsnow plays, I don't think he's going to be much of a. Like, impact on T-side.
With his AKD combo, you think it's gonna work out?
Nah, because he plays, like, extremely passive. That's how he gets the picks. Most of his picks are, like, falling back. As Awakening force buys into this last round. Trying to get a few more rounds. Double smoking CT and Bionify gets the M4A4 headshot. As two Awakening members get the and he still gets the double smoke. Double smoke, another one! 3k! 4k for Bossman! Oh my god. They get mauled down. 8-2 right now for Cadence. I am blending the ball. Holy.
Disappointed, bro.
Let's see. Awakening. 8-8. The rest of them negative.
Wait, who's your team?
Jason. The rest of his team are below 4 kills.
Nyx and Krims. 2-10 in 3 and
2. You've only gotten 2 kills in a total of 10 rounds. That's astonishing.
I thought Chris was gonna do a lot better. He said he's like a star player on Awakening.
I don't know. I feel as though like after that NSCO mod came out, Chris has been underperforming lately.
Half-time commercial.
I got you.
No F.
Como están? Me llamo Ricardo Santiago José III, and I will be introducing to you Colgate Optic White. You put this on your teeth, white. Okay. My man Dwight, his name is White, okay? He loved Colgate Optic White.
Yo, my name is John. And whenever you take a fat shit and you got no paper, no. That's not the good thing to do, alright? What you gotta do, you gotta buy some Charmin Ultra Soft, alright?
Charmin? What the fuck, bro? Try to do some commercials. Any year now. Thank you. Anyways, so
as I was saying, let's say you take a massive shit. You got no toilet paper. If you buy Charmin Ultra Soft, extra packaging, you won't have to go through this problem. You wipe your ass just with one little fucking sheet of paper, and you're all set. That shit will be wiped clean like a baby's bottom. Alright? Looks like the game's, let me just give the mic back over to dude.
So then your butt is gonna sound like a butt. Wait, not sound, feel like.
Oh, you want music prepared for the commercial? Yeah, I got you, man. I got you. Guys, whenever you lose a girlfriend and you want another one, thank you. Have fun putting no copyright intended.
Can you get copyright off a SoundCloud rapper? Is that how it works?
Yeah.
I don't think that's how it works.
You could just be like, all of the music in my video is not mine. No copyright.
Disclaimer, intended. Bro. That's all you need.
Yeah.
There's no
special. Looks like we're gonna need a halftime show over here. Dude Z, let's see what you got with them dance moves.
Alright.
Oh.
I call this the AK strafe, bro.
Oh. Oh, coming from an offer. That's that Lady Gaga stuff right there, boy.
What are we waiting for?
Alright guys, we're gonna have a brief intermission as I have to take a massive shit. And good thanks to Charmin Ultra Soft extra packaging, I can now take a massive shit. I'll be right back.
My god.
Dude.
Yo, I'm back. The people want parkour. Let's see. You want to see that massive parkour? Insane parkour coming from L1. Let me just toggle this sprint. Bang. Now check this out. I'm the best parkour ever. Boom. 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 I love he makes it up the ladder. Let's see if L1. Oh, he gets the jump. Ooh, lands the other jump. Ooh, lands the other jump. Ooh. Ooh. Oh shit. No!
I think the white thing got their head split about.
That's the number two, folks.
You might take on my pants.
Let's see who can get farther. You need ZK or almost ZK.
Like, Carmi parkour is Z. So watch this.
Hey, they call me that too.
I already. Oh, I thought you missed. Crap. Okay, well, I'll let you in.
Let's go. Oh, Elmon. Elmon! No! Fuck. Elmon falls.
I think Kane's gonna win this round. I'm just win after that.
Alright, Alohi, if you don't have it on already, I want you to turn on IRC mode for the better Mindplex mod, alright? And everybody check chat.
Okay.
Good job, guys.
Oh, X is mad.
Fine.
Oh, I'm just kidding.
Hello, amen.
Ah, damn, man. Like, come on, Awakening, step up. I didn't leave you like this.
Do you think Awakening will be taking their second ring of the season?
Believe it or not, I'm not sure. I have high hopes for Awakening. Unless I join. So, you know, I was on CSGO earlier today, right? And I see Jason on. I was like, whoa, Jason's on. You remember that MG1 challenge we had? Click on Jason. Check his CSGO profile. He's the opposite of MG1. He's gold level 1.
I guess he lost the race, huh?
Looks like we're back into this. Aiden's on T side. 8-2 so far.
E-split?
Man, I gotta... Hold on, I gotta switch teams. There we go. Alright. Looks like Cadence is doing a nice ultimate push into apartments. But I gotta turn off this toggle screen. You know, this is annoying when I'm spectating. Alright, so looks like Krim Z is aware of the situation. Falls back to balcony as Cadence members slowly make their way up into apt. Cadence awakening girls need. Cadence playing boiler. That's a Cadence. Jason playing boiler. He sees one head. Sorry, Yellowstone. There's a need deep in the balcony. Chris suffers 3 hearts of damage. As Scenix gets a pick on Epically for P2000 Fire Elemental. What a nice skin. More case. Oh, Jason Man 3 jumps out with the P2000. Gets a pick on Boxman. 3v5 situation for Cadence. As Jason Man gets another bomb down. The T apps. Florin gets a pick on Scenix with P2000 headshot, but Crims gets a pick on Balance side with 250. Last Cadence member all the way in mid. Florin gets a pick on Jason Man, but Krims gets a trade off. It's 3-0. Alright. So it's a 1-0, but in reality it's 8-3. If you're one of the new viewers out here, MSCL, we have like this thing where you add on to the last half. So last half was 8-2. Adding on to this, it'll be 8-3, alright? Krim Z jumping over, he thinks this is CSGO, just like trying to be hop, like get out of here with that nonsense. As Kenneth make their way into Banana. I think, Lawrence says my bad, but he actually meant to go B. As Scenix got the fucking skull headshot, that's like pretty rare to get out here in my place. Scenix aiming down. Gets another tag. Tags another one. Gets the pick on Heartless. I think bombs down. Try to tag another one. He gets tagged himself by P250. Florin gets destroyed by Jason with the skull. And Krim Z gets a knife and Jason made the other pick. What a flawless round.
It's a repeat of what Cadence did.
If I were Cadence right now, I'd accept the loss for this round, and I wouldn't even buy P250s to begin with. Like, I'd do a full eco. Like, just Glock train. Like, you know what I'm saying?
3 P250s.
Oh, no, that's not good. that could be a helmet right there. Not even, that could be a high explosive. That's a lot right there. Krims gets 296. Another high explosive. 5v3 situation for Cadence. Two of them are in the T-Apps. Thrown in a pistol exchange with Jason Man. Jason Man gets a knife kill on Epically. 2v5 situation for Biona Fine Thorn, the OG Cadence members. He gets destroyed by P90. I feel like this is these are the only rounds that Krims could ever get a kill. I'm joking. Whoa, ref gets DDoSed? What happened? No, I'm joking. Warren, 1v5 situation with a pizza 15. See if he could get any damage into the economy. Or will this be two flawless rounds again for Awakening? And it looks like it's another flawless round. Alright. Well, it looks like Awakening is returning the favor as it's now 8-5 right now. They're catching up. See if Cadence decides to buy. And yes, they did. As Epically buys an op, it's ready to peek mid. These two crossover.
Apple is a new main offer for Cadence.
This is a shot. As three Cadence members make their way into apps slowly, two Cadence members just lurk. Decent man, playing a little aggressive. That's the information. Mothman gets picked. Decent falls back. Scoping down mid. There's now four Cadence members playing extremely passively. One member in apps. Flash drone. Nobody flashed. Let's spec Bionify right now. Let's see what he's gonna do. I feel like he's gonna do an entry. What are your thoughts on Bonafide, dudes, considering he's your ex-teammate?
Well, he's doing pretty good right now. He's top right, he's tied for top.
And he gets fucking flicked by Jason. What a shot. Jason gets another shot. Ooh, Jason, he's no one. He's pick with the M4A4. It's 3k so far for Jason when he gets the 4k.
Or fall this round in a row.
Florin, smart decision. Saving this. Oh no, that's AFK. Saving this up so you could buy for his teammate, probably, if they want to quasi buy into this next round. Or will they have a Guardian up? Who knows?
I'm gonna follow this round with my awakening. No casualties.
What the fuck?
Epic because it gets a pick. Epically gets a pick on William, tossing out mid. Peeks in again. He's waiting for Jason to peek. Will Jason peek? See if he has a game sense. He does not peek. What a smart guy.
What is that?
Well, what the fuck, bro? Fuck out of here.
Who was that?
Oh, Shrimp.
Oh. Missed you.
You know, let me just serve him you while I commentate, you know what I'm saying? So this is a 5v4 situation for Awakening. Cadence is slowly making way to the B as they have another Awakening member. They have an Awakening member rotating. Jason. It'd be smart for Cadence to rotate for Shay. Oh wait, never mind. Oh, what is Jason doing? Like, he's wasted a bunch of time just like running back in speedway and just running back out.
You have a 3-man stack on B right now. And guess where Cadence is gonna go?
3-man stack.
Yeah. Oh, we get 2.
Jason, man, rotating back.
Jason rotating back.
Jason gets a pick. Boss man, 2v2 situation. Jason, man, gets another pick. And he gets another pick.
Them.
What a 4k. 21 kills so far for Jason. They're just feeding him right now, to be honest. I'm not sure. These are like two strong teams, but I don't think they're really like tier one material, if you know what I'm saying.
No one on Awakening has double digits except for Jason, and he has 21.
No, considering Awakening is top of the scoreboard in the league, I don't think they're like performing like Jason is carrying them single handedly. 22 kills for Jason so far. Yellow's not getting a pick. 4v4. Let's see if Cadence could like play off of this pick. That's just an Awakening member in Mexico. Let's see what he does. Looks like it's Dojo Dog of Skill. He scopes in, he's lit. 3 hearts, 2.5 hearts. He gets picked off by Sir Yellowstone. 3v4 situation. Oh. As Cadence make their way into B.
There goes Jason.
There's Jason down. 2v4 situation. There's one guy on the B site. All alone. William with a PP bias. And he gets picked off by bot spam. This is a clear opening for Awakening to go into B. It's a 1v4 situation for Krims. All the way in mid. Krims has 6 hearts, and he has an AK-47.
I think it's going to be 9-7 for Cadence, no?
9-7? What are your predictions for the rest of the game?
I think Awakening is going to win the round after this. And the round after this. Yeah, Cadence is going to speed up.
Well, if you think about it, all Cadence needs is 2 more rounds after this one to win the game.
I think if Cadence is, I guess, the first, they have a good chance. And if the first kill is Jason, then they win. Yeah, that's just what I'm going to say.
They need one more win. Just to tie the game.
Yeah.
Awakening has to win 3 straight without losing. I think it's possible, but, you know, there's always room for mistakes. Looks like Awakening is doing their same strategy again with Jason Boiler, William Archway, and Krim's Balcony. He's playing a little aggressive right now. He flashes and mollies. Awakening. Like, playing extremely passive. Depending on the sound horn. Epically, constantly trying to get the pick at mid. He's someone I'd be car trying to op. He's like, yo, you want to fight me? He's like, nah. Epically stays in now. Hold on. Alright, I'm back. Let's see. Poor situation.
They get stuck.
24 for Cadence. Wow, this is I'm a little afraid for Cadence right now.
Are they gonna choke like an 8-2 half, bro? Can't do that. Jason on 24 kills, and not a single Awakening member has the 10 kill goal other than Jason.
Alright, like, this map is actually low-key T-sided, but you're just playing it extremely passive, both sides. Like I predicted, Sir Yellow Snow wasn't gonna turn up as much as he did last game.
Yeah.
Considering he passed, he plays extremely passive. I think Hyde would have been a lot better to play on T-side, since he's a very aggressive player. Could have gone those key entries.
And IGL they have. Only IGL they have.
I think he's OGLing right now.
Oh, is he?
Most likely. Awakening making their way up. Trying to push into apps. But they keep constantly getting denied by smoke flashes. And Jason with the op. William gets a pick. AK. On Bonify. Jason gets a pick on Bot's Bane with the AWP. 2v5. Florian gets a pick on Jason. This is actually an open round for them. Considering Jason has been hardcore carrying them. All they need is one more pick and they could get the A-site easily. Sir Yellowsnow making a bad decision. Just pushing in all by himself. As Awakening. As Cadence pushes into Balcony. Learning epically the duel. Same skins. Florin gets picked. 3v1 situation for Florin.
With 5 seconds left. It's not happening.
William gets a pick. 7-1.
It's tied 9-9. If Awakening wins, they win. If Cadence wins,
they tie.
So I guess Awakening's winning now. Cadence has to do something big. They've been too predictable so far. and like, you know, go out there at least and do something.
Yeah. Awakening with the same setup. If I were to be Cadence, I'd push up
Mythar, I'll just go Mythar just.
Or you like smoke off Boiler, yeah, do that same strat. Like William, I don't think he's getting the pressure.
Fix too slowly and feeding Jason. Not a good
idea. So yeah, let's just give up a free life over. Yeah. 4v5. Another pick. 3v5. 5v2. That's game.
Jason, 28 kills. And not a single, another single awakening member had 10 kills.